Thrive Kitchen, Chef Todd here. So glad to be with you. You know, it's already October, fall is in the air. We have a great show for you coming up. We're featuring three delicious soups that's gonna keep you warm this fall as you thrive. If you're ready for something spicy and something packed full of protein, this Thrive black bean soup is right up your alley. First, we're gonna start with some butter. Put it into a hot pan. Yes, you're gonna get a little melty. You're gonna get a little sizzle. We call that the Thrive sizzle. So right here, put a little garlic in. That's 1 tablespoon of garlic. Take an average wood spoon. Give that a stir. Get the flavors and the aromatics in that pot. You wanna develop that pot. Next to flavor the pot would be some Thrive sausage. Now this is just thrown in dry, okay? We're using a method we call throw and go. And most soups are pretty much this way when it comes to Thrive. Now I've got a little heat on here. I've got a little roasty toasty. I'm gonna add another ingredient, the onions. And I'm gonna let these onions get a little toasty. You could burn these pretty easy, but if you keep rolling it around and get a little toast on it, that flavor, that toast flavor is going to impute into the soup. You can also see that I've got great color and great flavor on the bottom of this pan, which will create one of the most important parts of cooking, the deglaze, which is pulling and abstracting that flavor and those caramelized bits from the bottom of the pan and allowing those to disperse into the liquid. Oh baby, the Thrive sizzle, the water instantly pulls that deglaze, that caramelization right off the bottom of the pan. We're gonna add 8 cups of water. So we have garlic butter, Thrive sausage, Thrive onions in the pot so far, and we deglazed with the water. Give that a stir, and you wanna scrape the bottom of the pan to allow those flavors to really explode into that liquid, which is creating a broth, which is what soup is. Okay, now we add Thrive green chilies. Also, our Thrive celery is gonna go down. Okay, add that in. Then we're gonna take regular black beans, they're dried, but these aren't just your average black beans. These are Thrive's instant black beans. So add the black beans right into the water as well. Now we get down to the flavoring. Now this is the important part. You wanna put a little seasoning and spice in there. So of course, go to your go-to, which is Thrive Chef's Choice All-Purpose Blend Seasoning. Okay, so add that right in there. We're gonna add a little bit of cumin, a little bit of chili powder, a little bit of Thrive cilantro. That's gonna give it a nice refreshing flavor. A little bit of Thrive salt. And how could we go wrong with adding a little bit of Thrive tomato powder? The tomato powder is gonna give it some acidity, it's gonna give it some richness, it's gonna be absolutely delicious. So once you have those ingredients in there, there's a couple ingredients remaining. Thrive beef bouillon, which we're gonna add now and allow that bouillon to kind of release. So after you have all those ingredients in the pot, you wanna bring it up to a simmer, which is almost simmering now. And then you wanna basically allow the Thrive vegetables, the celery, the onions, the beans, to basically, once they stop floating and go into the soup, you know that they've grabbed onto that moisture and that liquid and been able to be reconstituted and tenderized enough. It's kind of my little tidbit on watching or seeing or listening to the food. Just allow that to sink and go into the soup. When that happens, you pretty much know you're ready to rock. You could just serve it like this if you wanted a chunky soup. If you want a smooth soup, you need to go to the blender. I actually kind of like it smooth, so I am gonna add the finishing touches of Cholula. That'll spice it up just a little bit, and that's always optional. You don't ever have to add hot sauce. That's, remember, you Thrivalize your food how you want. And we're also gonna add a little touch of lime juice, okay? That'll give it a nice refreshing flavor. Then last but certainly not least, that Jack cheese. We're gonna fold that right in like that, and then that's gonna be pureed right into the soup. That's gonna give us some creamy cheesy notes. And I add it last because we don't want it to add first and let that meld in and get all cheesy and stringy. So now we just turn the stove right off, put this right into the Wild Side Blend Tech. I always throw a towel over there too for safety measures. Okay. That should do it right there. So you can imagine to yourself what's going to happen when you puree those green chilies, when you puree that Thrive sausage and those black beans and those onions. You can imagine the flavor burst that comes now from the blender into our pot. You can see that it's about the right consistency for soup. You really don't want it any thicker than that or any thinner. It should definitely come off the spoon. We call that nappe. When it coats the spoon, that's thick enough. So there's your soup. Very simple, very easy. Now we're ready to plate up. Now look, I know when you make this soup, you're going to just want to grab a ladle, put it in a bowl, put some chips on it, and go to town, which is fantastic. Do that. But if you want to turn it up a notch and you have some guests over and you want to maybe impress them, show them how Thrive can really be gourmet. Simply take your soup, have a nice dish, take your soup, fill it up. Don't ever fill it so full that it's overfilling. Okay? You just want to put your soup right in there about just over halfway up the soup. Then we're going to add a couple little tasty treats. This is chili oil. So add a little bit of chili oil. It's kind of spicy, gives you a little boom. This is like a cilantro cream made with our sour cream, our cilantro. You can put a little jazz of that on there like this. That's going to give it a little creamy note. And then we're going to take just a little bit of fresh cilantro and some of these beautiful, brilliant tortilla strips. We're going to put the tortilla strips right down there. And we're going to take this fresh cilantro. We're just going to rip that up just a little bit and put that right on top of that as well. And simply, you have a gourmet soup. Look how simple, look how gourmet, and very tasty. And it's very actually inexpensive. You can do this soup for under $1 a serving. So really, this is the way to go. It's so convenient, it's so Thrive. It's so in your home every month. So glad to have you here, Black Bean Soup. Oh baby. Welcome everybody to the Featured Chef segment here on Thrive It Up, and man, do we have the perfect recipe for the month of October. It comes from our dear friend from the state of Wisconsin, Andy Schwichuan. Congratulations, Andy, on Chef Todd selecting you for the Featured Chef for the month of October. Just a little bit about Andy, Chef. She's been a consultant since October. Yeah, coming up on a year.
Coming up
on
a year.
It's a great year anniversary for her is you selecting her for the Featured Chef.
She wants to use her earnings from Thrive to build her dream house, one cookie at a time. So she's right on her way. She's doing great. But I had the privilege of testing this recipe. When I saw all the recipes, I literally put them out all over the counter. And we selected these very, very carefully this month. The pumpkin cookie for October just seemed perfect. And you know what? Here's what surprised me.
This cookie.
Andy didn't put any butter in the recipe.
What? No butter?
No butter. And I looked at it and I'm like, Andy, are you serious? You didn't put butter in the recipe for cookies?
Did she just leave it out?
Well, I think she left it out on purpose.
Oh,
here's
purpose.
Why. One, thank you very much because I am on a diet. And now these cookies are pretty much a low-fat pumpkin cookie. Now, of course, you can add a half a stick of butter, a stick of butter, whatever you want to do. We tried it both ways, and her cookies are fine. Of course, they're a little bit more dense, but they're healthier. There's no butter. So in the first time in all my life, and when I saw no butter, I actually started twitching. No butter.
We know
so
how much you like
the
butter.
The first time in my life, I ate a cookie with no butter, and I actually enjoyed it. This is a perfect way to show how Thrive can make things nutritious and easier and easy to use.
And delicious.
So, great little cookie. Pumpkin cookies for October. Andy, you did really a great job. Thank you for helping me lose. This is the healthy cookie. coming at you this month, Thrive October.
Thank you, Andy, and congratulations on being selected as the featured chef for the month of October. If you would like to be like Andy, get your recipe selected, get those recipes submitted on the Thrive Life recipe site. Let's build that database. We want Chef Todd to fill this table and every other table in the kitchen, having to have him make his decision on the featured chef. So congratulations. I'm about to eat this, Chef, and I will say, on camera, this is my sixth cookie in the last 15 minutes.
That's true.
These cookies are the bomb. Thank you, Andy. See you next month.
Thanks so much. Our next recipe here in the Thrive Kitchen, a classic mulligatawny soup, which is apple chicken curried soup. It's fantastic. That may sound a little odd, but it's really, really delicious. And our Thrive Granny Smith apples and our Thrive seasoned chunk chicken, are you kidding me? How easy and how convenient is that? So again, this is all the ingredients. I didn't dice the onions. I did not dice the carrots. I did not cut the celery or the apples or the chicken. Not a lot of ingredients. This is a simple, fun recipe. This recipe, one of our ways to thrive, Elias, or thrive, is to throw and go. This is a perfect example of throw and go. This is more of a stew recipe. So literally, we add water to a pan. We've got the heat on high. And then literally, we throw the ingredients in. Thrive seasoned chopped chicken. This is our Thrive chicken bouillon. Done. Thrive freeze-dried celery. Thrive carrots. Thrive Granny Smith apples that I'm going to wait. Thrive freeze-dried sliced onions. And I want to show you how magnificent these babies are. These are our new sliced onions. Big, hearty, gourmet. That's our Thrive onions. Then we're going to add about a tablespoon and a half, and you can add more or less to your liking, of yellow curry. Of course, it can't be great without the Thrive Chef's Choice All-Purpose Blend seasoning. Now, we're going to take the last three ingredients, which is our velouté sauce powder, our Granny Smith apples, and a little bit of heavy cream, and add that in about 5 minutes after this has simmered and allowed those flavors to really burst. Now the carrots, the onions, the celery, and the chicken, yes, they're freeze-dried, but now they're not. They're in the pot starting to stew and release the packed full flavor of the chicken, celery, onions right into that broth. Remember, the secret of a good soup is the broth. You've got to make sure that liquid tastes brilliant. And what other way to do that than to add a whole bunch of Thrive ingredients to a pot of soup? So this is going to be great. This is all stirred in and blended well. Now just allow it to sit in the hot tub, 7 minutes, simmer, and then we'll finish with the last three ingredients, simmer for a little while longer, and then enjoy a Thrive mulligatawny. So after you've literally smelled up your entire kitchen with the aroma of mulligatawny soup, what a delicious little blessing. Okay, then you're going to add your velouté sauce. You're going to sprinkle that in ever so lightly so that it disperses evenly. This is going to give the soup a little bit of body and also a little bit of flavor. Okay, you can see how that's already thickened that up slightly. And you don't, this soup isn't necessarily a thick, creamy soup. It's got a little splash of cream and a little thickness. It's more of a brothy style soup. But you can see the Thrive ingredients have literally just burst and popped in that broth. Now we can add the apples. The apples definitely are going to change the flavor profile. They're going to add some tartness, some acidity. They're going to add texture. It's just a delicious way to go. So once those apples are mixed in, the sauce is mixed in, go ahead and hit it with your cream. Make sure you get every last drop. Now everything is in the soup that you'll need for the mulligatawny. So you want to just allow these ingredients to come together for 3 to 5 minutes. That's it. And then guess what? It's time to eat and enjoy. After you've allowed these flavors to come to the pot and the mulligatawny is screaming, eat me, then certainly dish it up. So this is very simple, nice rustic classic soup, chicken curry with apples. Delicious, easy. I simply garnish with just a little salad blend seasoning. And that's really all you need for a magnificent bowl of mulligatawny soup. This is Thrive Mulligatawny from the Thrive Kitchen, Chef Todd. Enjoy this recipe. For another delicious, glorious recipe right out of the Thrive Kitchen. Yes, Thrive Asparagus Soup. Wait a minute, did I say asparagus soup? I did. Thrive Asparagus Soup. Drum roll, hello! Yeah, so here we go. It's gonna be a smooth soup, a pureed soup. We're gonna make a broth using some delicious Thrive ingredients. First, we're gonna start with 1.5 tablespoons of garlic and some delicious olive oil. We're gonna let those two flavors come together using a wood spoon. Allow those to kind of toast, slightly sweat together so that the flavors can release. Then we're gonna add ever so slightly Thrive freeze-dried onions and allow that to toast as well as sweat together with the garlic. And this is gonna create our base. So you can see how simple and easy those flavors are coming together. Go ahead and add the celery. And then hit it with your 5 cups of water. Any of the flavor that's stuck to the bottom of that pan is now off and into the broth. Now we're gonna season the broth with a little bit of chicken bouillon. This is actually vegetarian chicken bouillon. So those of you who are vegetarian or staying away from meats, this is a flavoring bouillon that takes the flavor of chicken, but not actually chicken. So it's multi-purpose, very tasty, very delicious. We're gonna add Thrive peppercorn blend seasoning, Chef's Choice all-purpose blend seasoning, Thrive, Thrive salt, and Thrive Italian blend seasoning. Once you get all those seasonings and spices into the pot, stir that up as well. And again, you're gonna be able to see instantly a broth starting to form and the liquid starting to come together and the Thrive pot of love taking place. This is the essence of soup. Create that base flavor with your flavoring profiles, generally mirepoix, carrots, onion, celery. But in this case, our main profile is asparagus. So now we add the asparagus right into the pot. And we stir this up. And you can see really quickly the asparagus reconstitutes right when it hits the water, comes back to its perfect form or shape. Now we're gonna allow those flavors and ingredients to pop out. And instantly, the aromatics of that asparagus is hitting me, the steam is hitting me, because that is what the soup's gonna, the flavor profile is just gonna push, asparagus. But the celery, onions, garlic, that chicken bouillon, those are all helpers in that profile of asparagus. But at the end of the day, it's asparagus that's the star of the soup. Allow this to simmer for about 5 to 7 minutes until you can see the vegetables get soft, completely immerse themselves into the liquid, and then we're gonna go to the blender. After the asparagus soup is simmered, you can see everything's reconstituted, soft, delicious. The aromatics, I mean, it just screams asparagus. It smells so delicious. So this soup is gonna be a pureed soup. So again, we're gonna go to the blender, add all of the product right to the blender. Take your towel again.
Remember, don't fill it more than 3/4 full, or you could have an accident. Okay, now watch this new clean pan. Beautifully smooth puree of asparagus, celery, onions, garlic. Natural, delicious. What we want to show you is how to finish this soup up. So I've got some bacon cooking. You can see how delicious, caramelized that bacon's gonna be. Oh, baby, that smells delicious. And then we have some red bell peppers, onions, and asparagus tips. And yes, I did go through the can and pick all the good tips out because that's gonna be my garnish. But to finish the soup, we're gonna take 2 cups of cream and add it right to the asparagus soup. Okay, stir this in. Once you get that stirred in, we're gonna add some rice wine vinegar. Okay, this rice wine vinegar actually goes delicious with the asparagus. Gives it the acidity that the soup needs and makes it really, really heavenly. Stir that rice wine vinegar in. And now I'm just bringing that back up to a slow, slight simmer. Now that the cream's in, it's a little bit more delicate. So we're gonna just bring that up to a simmer. Okay, once your bacon has pretty much gotten brown, go ahead and drain some of that fat off. You do not want all of that bacon grease in there. You want some, but not all. So just allow that to drain slightly. Okay, now that's delicious. Then you've got to reconstitute your vegetables for the garnish. So I add just a little bit of water and I'll just tumble this and rehydrate this asparagus, onions, and peppers. Once that's rehydrated, go ahead, add that right into the pan with the bacon. Leave the bacon grease right in there. Put it back on the heat. Look how delicious that is. That is absolutely, seriously wonderful. I'm gonna add a little bit of salad blend seasoning. This is parsley and chives and little bits of red onion. So right after you add that salad blend seasoning, go ahead and season that up with some Chef's Choice all-purpose blend seasoning as well. And that's the garnish. That's gonna be pretty much good. So we have this smooth, silky, creamy, delicious asparagus soup going right into our bowl. Look at the brilliant color. Wonderful. And then you take, that's the smooth portion, then you take all of our favorite things, asparagus, bacon, peppers, onions, and that's gonna be the garnish right into the soup so that you still have some nice, crunchy, whole texture. You can put some chili oil, you can put a little sprig of basil, whatever you wanna do. That's gonna be delicious. I know you'll enjoy this. This is Chef Todd, Thrive Kitchen. Happy fall!
Everybody to the Thrive It Up segment, hashtag
Ask Chef Todd.
Bart Mills, we have our great chef with us today, and an awesome question that's come in via Facebook this month comes from Betsy Cash.
Betsy Cash.
And she has a question about our honey crystals, Chef.
Great question, by
this,
the way.
This is what she asks, hashtag Ask Chef Todd, I want to use my honey crystals in more dishes. How do you use the honey crystals? And can you demo rehydrating the crystals?
You bet you, Betsy. That's our specialty.
You ask Betsy. Chef
honey crystals.
Answers.
Our honey crystals are fantastic. It does have real honey in this. So don't think that it's just a sugar product. It does have real honey. It's real honey in all aspects of the game. So this is how it comes. So it's dry little crystals. This lends itself well to breads, baked items, anything that calls for honey, you can literally sprinkle the crystals right in and you're going to get similar effect as you would with regular honey, using it in dry form. Much like our butter powder, shortening powder is great for baked goods, baked for adding in, stuff like that. If you were going to make a chicken teriyaki, and you wanted a honey in there as your sweetener, yeah. just sprinkle this right into the sauce. It'll reconstitute. It'll be beautiful.
Great idea.
So how I use it is exactly like that. I use it in my baked products. I use it in my cooking, my sauces, my marinades. We use it for a lot of things, flavoring drinks, flavoring your breads, flavoring your muffins, all kinds of ways to use it dry. Now, of course, it reconstitutes just fine. Add a little bit of water, and a little bit of water kind of goes a long way.
You're just eyeballing this right now, right?
I'm just eyeballing
it. Add a little bit at a time.
Of course, the can is going to tell you how to reconstitute. Okay?
Okay.
So you saw how little water I added.
Yeah, very little.
And look how runny it's going to get. So you do not need to add a lot of water. Now, the best thing to do is just add water and then let it reconstitute. It does take a little bit of time. If you want to speed the process up, just take your container, hit it in the microwave a little bit. As soon as this hits a little bit of heat, it'll reconstitute just like
Makes
that.
Sense.
Then store it in the refrigerator after reconstituting. You can make a big batch of honey and then have honey in your fridge all the time. And it's no problem.
Would it heat, you can see that
it's already starting to reconstitute much better.
Would it speed up the process if you reconstituted it with hot water?
Yes, hot water. And again, you do not need a lot of honey, a lot of water in with the honey at all.
Yeah, you can see it right now. I don't know what you call that.
It's moving. Yep, it's reconstituting. And those crystals are just going to break down.
Wow.
Basically, the sugar part of the honey is breaking down and basically turning into like a syrup.
And let's be honest, anything's better with honey, right?
Anything's better with honey, absolutely. So, very simple. And again, if you want to speed this up and you want instant honey, you will need to warm this slightly. If you're not in a hurry, just reconstitute it with a little bit of water and it will dilute down. But the honey is better if you just slightly warm it and it'll actually melt. And then it'll be more like a syrupy consistency. And again, if you want it thicker or thinner, just adjust your water. If you want it thicker, don't add very much water in it. It just takes like that. But the instructions are on the can. But certainly, once you start thriving, once you get into your food, you don't need instructions because you are thrivalizers. You can just make
honey,
it happen.
It's honey in the bank.
Honey in the bank. Thank you very much, Betsy.
Great question. If you have a question like Betsy and like to have Chef Todd answer it here live on Thrive It Up, go ahead and use the hashtag.
#ChefTodd.
Post it on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, whatever you prefer, and we will select it and answer it here on Thrive It Up. We'll see you next month, guys.